Hey everyone, this is Veronica Wasek with 5-Minute Bookkeeping, and today I'm showing you how I review my clients' books in just 15 minutes using my smart review system. So how do I review my clients' books in just 15 minutes? Well, I use a checklist and I use my smart review system. And my smart review system is basically a way for me to just do a very quick and fast review of my clients' books to get a sense of the biggest problems that they have with their QuickBooks file. So it's not an in-depth review, but it certainly gives you a lot of information about the state of their books, about some of the biggest problems that they have, so that you can point these things out to them and then be able to sell additional services to them. So I'll go ahead and show you my system. And we're looking here at the smart review checklist that I put together. And again, you can claim that for free. Just look in the description box below. We have a few sections here for banking, undeposited funds, profit and loss, balance sheet. So it's very quick, very simple. Again, not a full comprehensive system, but something to help you to uncover your client's biggest problems. So we'll go ahead and get started. So for banking, it's asking to review the list of bank and credit card accounts for any personal accounts being included in QuickBooks Online. We certainly come across this quite a bit. And from the chart of accounts, we can see the list of bank accounts as well as a credit card. And in some cases, you do have to ask the client whether they have included any personal accounts in QuickBooks. But we do see that happen from time to time. You do need to look for that and ask about it. Next is to review for any old transactions still in the banking window or in the bank feeds. Okay, so we're going to the bank feeds. The year that we're working with in our sample company is 2021. And you can see that there are quite a few transactions still for 2021. So that would be an issue. That means that the client hasn't worked through all of the transactions in their bank feed. Next, review the last date that the bank and credit card accounts were reconciled. So have the accounts been reconciled? If so, when was the last time that they were reconciled? All right, so we can see in our sample company, the last date was September 30th of 2021. And if it was December of 2021, they would need to get caught up. Again, we're looking here for, have they reconciled the accounts? And if so, when was the last date? And you would do that for each account. Next step, and this is a really important one, review for old and uncleared items in the bank and credit card reconciliations. I'm going to look at the last reconciliation. This is one way in which you can do that. So from the reconciliation history by account, go to view report on the right. And this is the reconciliation report. You'll see a section showing you the items that have been cleared. And then you'll see where it shows you uncleared checks and payments. If there are uncleared deposits, you will also see that here. And you can see that there are many, many uncleared bank transactions. And so that is telling us that we probably have a lot of duplicate transactions as well as transactions entered incorrectly or maybe some invalid transactions. In fact, this client has $141,500 of uncleared transactions. So that's definitely a problem and something, again, that as you're looking at this very quickly, and talking to your client, you can point out that you're seeing some issues and that you would need to do a more in-depth review of their books to diagnose what's wrong with their books. Next, a review for any changes to bank reconciliation opening balances. All right, so from the reconciliation, if there are any changes, we will actually see that here. I'll show you. You'll see this error message showing that the account isn't ready to reconcile yet and that there's a difference of $38,000. So again, these are things that you can very quickly look at and let your client know that there's a problem. All right, next, review for any auto adjustments made to the bank reconciliations. So again, if we go to the history by account and look for auto adjustment, we'll see that we have an $18 adjustment. Next, undeposited funds. So we're going to review for undeposited funds and actually review for old balances. From the plus sign, select bank deposit. And you're looking for old balances in undeposited funds. So the bank deposit window shows you what is in undeposited funds. And any old transactions are also signs of problems, usually meaning that the client doesn't have a proper workflow for entering their customer payments, and they have likely now entered income through deposits into QuickBooks and bypassing undeposited funds. And that is one of the biggest problems that we see with the undeposited funds account, is all of these old balances, and all of these have to be addressed and cleaned up. Then we'll move on to the profit and loss report. And we're looking for unusual balances, unexpected balances, uncategorized income, uncategorized expenses. So we'll go ahead and look for these in the profit and loss report, looking from January through December of 2021. And we see that we have uncategorized income. We have some negative balances for job materials. We have uncategorized expense. I do see that we have a rather large balance in maintenance expense. I would consider that to be unexpected based on what I know about this client. I see here an $18 reconciliation discrepancy. Rent expense looks rather high for this business. Office decor also looks rather high. And also automobile maintenance and repairs look high, and actually advertising. Okay, so I'm looking for things that are unusual, unexpected, and as I said, uncategorized income, uncategorized expense. So these are, again, things that I can very quickly point out to my client. Our next step is to review for cost of goods sold transactions that are incorrectly categorized as expenses. And I can actually do this very quickly because I can just tell by looking at cost of goods sold that we only have $158 of cost of goods sold, and that we probably have then cost of goods sold expenses that are under the expenses category. Some of these job materials should probably be categorized under cost of goods sold, depending on the client, maybe even some of the subcontractor expenses. Next, review for large negative balances for income or expenses. And so I did point out already in the income section, we have negative balances for job materials, and I don't see anything else. And to review for miscategorized transactions, and I pretty much already pointed those out to you. All right, the next step is to review for miscategorized fixed asset additions. And usually I will look for those in accounts such as office supplies, office expenses, maintenance and repairs. So there might be some fixed asset additions that are incorrectly categorized under those accounts. So maintenance and repair, certainly there could be something there. And then office supplies, possibly under paper or office decor. Review for payroll expense being recorded incorrectly. Usually you want to see payroll recorded at gross rather than net. So we would be expecting to see payroll expenses as well as payroll taxes. Review for expenses recorded to reconciliation discrepancy. And we do have a negative $18 in reconciliation discrepancy that might be indicative of the client forcing their bank reconciliation to balance, so certainly a possible red flag there. Review for expenses and ask my accountant. So those would be expenses that do need to get categorized correctly. Review for personal expenses being recorded in the profit and loss report. Normally you'll see things that either they'll say personal expenses, such as what you see here. I have seen daycare, I have seen mortgage payments, I've seen lots of things. And review for unapplied cash payment income and unapplied bill payment expense on a cash basis. So we'll switch over to cash. And you'll see here that we have $44,000 in unapplied cash payment income and $80,000 in unapplied cash bill payment expense. Those two accounts are accounts that QuickBooks uses when transactions are not entered correctly. There's a long story behind how that happens, but those are also red flags and need to be corrected. Onto the balance sheet. We will be reviewing for unusual and unexpected balances, large negative balances, uncategorized assets, miscategorized transactions. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. So looking at the balance sheet as of 12/31/2021, you can already see that we have negative accounts receivable. So that is a problem. We have two different inventory accounts. We have uncategorized asset. We already know that we have a large balance in undeposited funds. So we looked at that just a little while ago. We have negative accounts payable. We also have negative federal income taxes payable. And then a negative opening balance equity. So there's quite a bit here that probably needs to be cleaned up. And definitely that bears doing a deeper diagnosis and review of the books. Review for miscategorized fixed asset additions. Here we would be looking for any additions to the fixed asset accounts that don't meet the criteria for capitalizing those fixed assets, and these look fine. Review for notes payable or loans payable and whether interest expenses being recorded incorrectly. Usually what we see when we look at the loans are that the same amount is being recorded every month. So that is a sign then that interest expense is not being recorded correctly. Next, you can review for payroll tax payments that are not recorded correctly. We are looking to see if payroll tax payments are being recorded to the payroll liabilities account. All right, so here then we can see that there are payments being entered to the liability account for their payroll liability payments. So that looks okay. And lastly, review for amounts being recorded to the opening balance equity account. And as you can see, we have a balance in opening balance equity, and we have several transactions recorded to the account in the current year. So just as a reminder, the Smart Review Checklist is just meant to give you a sense of some of the biggest problems that you will find in your client's QuickBooks files. It is not a comprehensive method for doing that. You might want to adjust the checklist for some of the things that you might think are important or additional things that you might want to review for. I do have a comprehensive diagnostic review system that I use for my clients, and that information is in the description box, as well as the link for you to claim the free Smart Review Checklist. I'm Veronica Wasek with 5-Minute Bookkeeping. If this content is helping you, make sure that you comment, like, share, and subscribe to my channel so you can get all of my latest videos.